this video, I'll talk about Cesar Beccaria and his ideas about crime and punishment. Cesar Beccaria is seen by many people as the father of criminology for his ideas about crime, punishment, and criminal justice procedures. He was an Italian born as an aristocrat in the year 1738 in Milan. At that time, European thought about crime and punishment was still very much dominated by the old idea that crime was sin and that it was caused by the devil and by demons. And in part to punish the devil and the demons that were causing crime, very harsh punishments were used. At the time when Beccaria came along, the era of Enlightenment was in full swing and scientists were starting to challenge the old views, but the people who had political power were not ready to leave those old ideas behind yet. Beccaria's famous work on crimes and punishments was published in 1764 when he was 26 years old. His essay called out the barbaric and arbitrary ways in which the criminal justice system operated. Sentences were very harsh, torture was common, there was a lot of corruption, there were secret accusations and secret trials, and there was a lot of arbitrariness in the way in which sentences were imposed. There was no such thing as equality before the law, and powerful people of high status were treated very differently from people who were poor and who did not have a lot of status. Beccaria's ideas clashed dramatically with these practices, and I'll go through some of the central principles that his work is based on. First, according to Beccaria, only the law can prescribe punishment. It is up to the legislator to define crime and to prescribe which punishment should be imposed. It is not up to a magistrate or a judge to impose a penalty if the legislator has not prescribed it. And neither is it up to a judge to change what the law says about how a crime should be punished. The judge should do exactly what the law says. In addition, Beccaria said that the law applies equally to all people, and so punishment should be the same for all people, regardless of their power and their status. Beccaria also believed in the power of making the law and law enforcement public. More specifically, laws should be published so that people actually know about them. And trials should be public too. Only then can onlookers judge if the trial is fair. Regarding severe punishment, Beccaria said that if severe punishments do not prevent crime, they should not be used. Instead, punishment should be proportional to the harm that a crime has caused. According to Beccaria, the aim of punishment is not to cause pain to the offender, but to prevent them from doing it again, and to prevent other people from committing crime as well. In order to be able to do that, Beccaria believed that punishment should be certain and swift. He believed that if offenders were sure that they would be punished, and if punishment would come as quickly as possible after the offense, that this would have the largest chance of preventing crime. As another controversial issue, Beccaria argued against the death penalty. Instead of torture and severe penalties, Beccaria believed that education is the most certain method of preventing crime. Beccaria's ideas are hardly controversial today, but they caused a lot of controversy at the time because they were an attack on the entire criminal justice system. Beccaria initially published his essay anonymously because he didn't necessarily consider it to be a great idea to publish such radical ideas. And this idea was partly confirmed when the book was put on the blacklist of the Catholic Church for a full 200 years. But even though his ideas were controversial back then, his essay became an immediate success. In fact, Beccaria's ideas became the basis for all modern criminal justice systems, and there is some evidence that his essay influenced the American and French revolutions, which happened not long after the publication of his essay. His ideas were not original because other people had also proposed them, but Beccaria was the first one to present them in a consistent way. Many people were ready for the changes that he proposed, which is why his essay was such a success.